Good morning, dear children. Let us continue the topic, the direct speech and indirect speech. We have already studied about the direct speech, indirect speech, changing the tense of the quoted speech according to the tense of introducing verb. Then we studied about the changing of pronouns, changing the adverbials. Now, in today's class, we shall discuss about change of narration for sentence style. You know that quoted speech is of different kind of sentences. There are four kinds of sentences we have studied. Declarative sentence, which is also known as assertive sentence. Then, imperative sentence, interrogative sentence and exclamatory sentences. Dear children, all these four kinds of sentences are changed into indirect speech in different ways. Some of the rules are getting changed, but some of the rules are similar for all type of sentences. So according to the sentence type, we are going to discuss in today's class. First, we shall study about declarative sentence. We'll study about declarative sentence. When the quoted speech is an assertive sentence or the declarative sentence, what are the rules we have to keep in mind? We are going to discuss about those rules. Clear? The reporting verb said is changed to told when an object is mentioned. Clear? After the introducing verb or the reporting verb, said is the introducing verb and it is followed by an object, me. In that case, when we change into indirect speech, said will be changed to told. And to will be omitted. Said will be changed to told. Clear? This happens only if the introducing verb is followed by an object. Clear? If it is not followed by an object, in that case, said remains said. So this is the first rule. When we change into indirect, your introducing verb is followed by an object. So said is changed to told. Clear? The second rule is, see here the sentence, Dheeraj said to me, I don't know the answer. I don't know the answer is the quoted speech. So Dheeraj told me, in the indirect speech it will be, Dheeraj told me that, we know that instead comma we use that. The conjunction, subordinating conjunction, that is used. Dheeraj told me that I will be changed to he. Do not, don't will be changed. Present tense is changing to past tense if the introducing verb is in simple past. So, do not, don't will be changed to did not, did. Clear? He did know the answer. Full stop. Okay? So, this was the first rule. Let's see the second one with the help of example. Elena said, Elena said, I'm very happy today. I am very happy today. Full stop, inverted comma, close. Said is introducing verb here, and dear children, this introducing verb is not followed by an object. So in this case, said will remain said only. It will not be changed into told because it is not followed by an object. Clear? So what will be its indirect form, Elena said that, instead comma we use the conjunction that, said that she, according to the subject, I will be changed to she. She, am, present tense will be changed to past tense. She was very happy. Today will be changed. The adverbials are getting changed. Today will be changed to that day. Full stop. The next, the third rule is, conjunction that is used to join the introducing verb and the quoted speech. Here you can see in the declarative sentences, conjunction that is used to join the main sentence with the quoted speech. Clear? And the tenses, personal pronouns and words denoting time, place and positions are changed according to the rules which we have discussed previously. Clear? Rest of the rules are same. Changing pronouns, changing tenses and changing the adverbials will remain same whatever we have already discussed. So this was about all these rules for about the declarative sentence. Now let us discuss about use of infinitives in indirect speech. Infinitives means the non-finite verbs. The combination of two plus verb. The combination of two plus verb is called infinitives. So, we sometimes use the following combination to replace the reporting verb say or said in indirect speech. Instead that we can use agree, offer, promise, refuse, written plus infinitive plus two plus verb form. For example, let us see. Rita said, I will not go. Rita said, I will not cook. Now, you can see it is the declarative sentence and here we can see Rita is refusing to do something. She is refusing to do something. So, instead the introducing verb said, we can use the word refused. Clear? Rita refused. Now, after this changes, we can use the infinitive. That is two plus verb. Clear? And what is the verb here? Cook is the verb. Okay, so Rita refused to cook. Likewise, using the infinitives also we can change from the direct to indirect speech. Now let us see the next topic, from indirect to direct. So far we studied changing from direct speech to indirect. Now we will discuss how to change from indirect speech to direct speech. The word say or said is most commonly used as the reporting verb. As the introducing verb, most commonly we use the verb say or said. Then in the indirect speech, you know, introducing verb and the quoted speech is joined together by using the subordinating conjunction that. When we change from indirect to direct, that subordinating conjunction is removed and instead that we use comma or the semicolon. Clear? And whatever is spoken by the speaker is written within the inverted comma or the quotation mark. The tense of the reported speech is changed if required. If it is required, the tense of the reported speech or the quoted speech will be changed. The pronouns, possessive adjectives or the adverbials will also change appropriately. The rules which I have already learned will remain same. Now, let me write here one example for you to make you understand in a better way. He said that he wanted to give his book to Raja. We know that this is the sentence which is given in the indirect speech. We have to change this into direct speech. Let us change. He said that will be removed. The conjunction will be removed. Instead that comma will be there, followed by the inverted comma. Now, whatever is spoken by the speaker will be placed within the inverted comma. He will be changed. The pronoun he will be changed to I, and the verb wanted. Wanted will be changed to want. I want to give. I want to give his. The possessive adjective his will be changed to mine. I want to give my book to Rajan. Full stop, inverted comma, close. I want to give my book to Rajan. Clear? So, likewise we make changes. Likewise we change from indirect speech to direct speech. Now, let us discuss about interrogative sentences. If your quoted speech is a question, we can see some different rules here. The first one is the reporting verb said is changed to asked or required. Clear? Said is changed to asked or inquired. But according to the sentence, according to that interrogative sentence, we can use some other words also, like demand, want to know, or wonder, and so on. These kind of words also can be used instead of said. Instead the reporting introducing verb said, we can use inquired, wondered, wanted to know, or demand. Clear? Demanded. So introducing verb is getting changed. Second one is, in the declarative sentence we use the conjunction that, but here we use the conjunction either if or whether. Either if or whether, these two conjunctions we can use. In the declarative sentence we use the conjunction that, but here we can use if or whether. When do we use if or whether? That also you have to learn. There are two types of interrogative sentences. One is the yes no type question. Another one is WH question. The conjunction if or whether is used only when the question is yes no type. When it is yes no type. Yes no type question means which is beginning with the auxiliary verb. Clear? Like do, does, did, have, has, had, is, am, are, was, were. When the question is beginning with all these auxiliary verbs, means it is a yes no type question, and for this kind of question we use the conjunction if or whether to join the introducing verb to the quoted speech. Now let me write here one example to make you understand. Rinki said, can I come with you? Rinki said, comma, inverted comma, open, sorry, can I come with you? Question mark, inverted comma, close. Now let me tell you the third rule. First we studied that said is changed to asked or inquired or demanded or wanted to know and so on. Clear? Second rule, I told you we use instead conjunction that, we use here if or whether when the sentence is yes no type. Clear? Third rule is, when we change this interrogative sentence, this direct speech to indirect, interrogative sentence will be changed into an assertive sentence. It will be no more question. It will be no more direct question. It will be converted to indirect question. Question will be changed to a statement. How? By changing the position of the verb and the subject. In the question, you know, verb comes first followed by the subject. But when we change it into a statement, subject will come first followed by the verb. Clear? So let us change this. Here you can see, Rinki is asking something.
Can I? Come with you. Is asking something. So said can be changed to asked. Rinki asked the conjunction. Can I come with you? It is beginning with the modal auxiliary. So it's yes no type question. So the conjunction if or whether will be used here. Clear? Rinki asked whether can I? It's a question. It will be changed to a statement. So subject will come first, followed by the word. I is the subject here. I will come first. I will be changed to, according to the subject, the pronoun I will be changed to she. Whether she can. We studied that can will be changed to could, will, would, shall, should. Modal auxiliaries are getting changed. So can will be changed to could. Whether she could come with, whether she could come with me. You will be changed to me. And as we have changed this question to a statement, there will not be question mark. There will be a full stop. Clear? So I hope this much is clear to you, all of you. Once again I will repeat. We use the conjunction if or whether when it is yes no type question. The introducing verb said can be changed to inquired, demanded, wanted to know or wondered, clear, and so on. And your question will change to a statement when you will be changing from direct to indirect speech. And other things will remain same. Changing the pronouns, changing the tenses, changing the adverbials will be same. Now this is what we discussed about the yes no type question. Let us discuss about WH question. What are the rules for WH question? Let me write you an example. Dear children, for WH questions we do not use any conjunction. Clear? For joining the introducing verb and the quoted speech, we do not use any conjunction. We join it using WH word itself. Now let me write here this example. The stranger said, comma, inverted comma, open, why isn't anyone here? Question mark, inverted comma, close. You can see here on the board the example which I wrote. Your quoted speech is beginning with WH word. Clear? So it is WH question. In that case, instead comma, we will not be using any conjunction. For changing said, the rules will be same. We can use inquired, wanted to know, demanded, and so on. Clear? No conjunction will be used here. We will join this quoted speech with the main sentence using WH word itself. Clear? And other rule, the question will be changed into assertive sentence as we did for yes no type question. Rest of the rules will remain same. Changing the pronouns, changing the tenses, changing the adverbials will remain same. Let us change this. The stranger wanted to know. The stranger wanted to know why. No conjunction, dear children. With WH word it will be joined. Why? Now see here, anyone is the subject. It will be changed. I told you, question will be changed to a statement. Subject will come first. It's negative sentence, so anyone will be changed to no one. Why? No one is will be changed to was. Present will be changed to past. Why? no one was here. Adverbial here will be changed to there. Clear?
Likewise, we change the WH question into indirect speech. I hope changing the declarative sentence and interrogative sentence from direct to indirect is clear to all of you. In the next class, we'll discuss about changing the imperative sentences and exclamatory sentences from direct to indirect. Thank you.